let's look at how Autodesk Smoke works with sync. There are two considerations when it comes to sync. Firstly, there is keeping sync in the sequence when editing. So if you have lots of tracks and you are only inserting into a few areas, you are not knocking everything out of sync. Secondly, we work quite frequently with video and synchronous audio. For example, if you're cutting a narrative or an interview spot. We'll try cover all these aspects in this video. Let's start off with keeping sync while editing. By default, when editing sources into the sequence, Smoke edits into the patch tracks as you would expect. However, there are plenty of scenarios that can occur that can throw the timeline out of sync. One common example is that I have two pieces of synchronous video and audio segments edited together. I would like to insert a video segment between the two as a cutaway or break in the edit. But I only want to insert the video and not the audio. So the patch panel is set to only edit video and not audio. I press F9 to perform an insert edit. The patched video track is edited, but nothing else. So my sequence is now out of sync because there was nothing done to keep the other tracks in sync. This is where the sync locks come in. These are toggle buttons located in the patch panel for every track. You can click them on to turn on individually, or press Shift and click the video tracks, and then Shift and click the audio tracks. If I press Command Z to undo the old edit, and I press the insert button again, Smoke will now insert gaps into all the tracks to maintain the sync in the edit. Having this on when you first start assembling an edit is very helpful to keep overall sync. As you start refining your edit, you might want to turn them off to avoid creating unnecessary gaps in the sequence. I'll disable mine for now. These are just a few sync tips, but the choices are up to you. The other aspect of sync is working with video and its synchronous audio. This is quite common. You can import them in as a sync group if they were captured that way, or you could create a sync group from a separate video and audio segment. To identify a sync group in the sequence, you will see that the segment description is underlined in all the related segments. Any other segments that are not underlined are just individual segments. Now you can tell Smoke to just select individual segments or select the sync group. This is all controlled through the link button in the row of editorial controls. When it is on, selecting any segment in a sync group selects the entire group. This means that as you move, trim, and edit segments around the sequence, you are able to keep perfect sync. For example, if you're experimenting with a potential edit. If link is turned off, then you can select any individual segment without their respective sync group. Even if you move individual segments from a sync group, they will always be part of that group. You could break the sync group by pressing Command L. The same keyboard shortcut will also create sync groups from individual elements. So if you have synced and selected a separate video and audio source together, just press Command L to create the sync group. So you've learned how to permanently break and create sync groups. Another useful function that you can do is temporarily enable or disable sync groups when you are editing. For example, you can adjust one segment without breaking the sync group. Let's say I want to trim out the video to create an offset edit. Even with link enabled, just press Option and click the segment you would like to affect. This temporarily selects just that segment and you can adjust it. Clicking the segment again, Smoke will reselect the whole sync group. The same goes in reverse. If link is off and you want to select a sync group without always having to toggle link on, just hold Option and click one of the segments in the sync group. This will select all the segments and you can perform your next operation with that selection. Without holding Option, Smoke will revert back to the regular behavior of selecting individual segments. The sync groups also have sync indicators when something is knocked out of sync. So moving other individual segments around the sequence could potentially disturb the sync. For example, I'll turn ripple on and press R to switch to trim mode. I'll adjust the tail of the segment before a sync group. The audio segments of the sync group display frame indicators that tell you how many frames the audio is out of sync with the video. At this point, you can do a number of things. You can physically move the video segment to be back in sync with the audio or vice versa. You can also slip the audio or video frames. But Smoke has a resync function. Right-click on the sync group. In the pop-up menu, you can choose Resync. This function will automatically slip the audio segments back in sync with the video without altering the edit. Another issue that can come up is when sync sound is slightly offset from the video. For example, audio that was captured during the filming of a faraway subject could create a slight delay between the action and the sound. The sync indicators think that the audio and video are in sync, but you know better. You can either turn off link or use the option toggle I showed you earlier to select the audio separately. Now move the specific audio until you're happy it's in sync with the video. Of course, the sync indicators will tell you that the audio is out of sync. To fix this, right-click on the audio segments and choose Reset from the pop-up menu. This will reset the sync connection in the sync group between the video and the audio. The video and audio are now in sync, and the sync group now accepts the new offset as the correct sync between the segments. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.